It's not that Japanese workers are better than American workers. In fact, quite the opposite is true. It's the managers, it's the leaders up above that are so bad in bringing out the best in their people. We spend half our waking lives at work, and I don't know where it's written in stone that we should all regard it as a form of punishment. And I think 90% of the chief executives out there, or some figure in that ballpark, are inadequate and are not doing their job. They've retired in their private offices. The way to get America's workforce moving again is to give them leaders. And when I get through giving you these characteristics, you'll know more about leadership than you did before.
Because participative management is coming so fast in this country, it seemed to me that what I could do to help would be to write a 3-hour PhD in participative management that was user-friendly.
Welcome to this Listen and Learn program, filled with useful information. This session is designed to sharply increase your awareness on the subject and give you ideas and knowledge that you can put to work right away. As with all Listen and Learn programs, you hear from the experts, people who have already been there and who have had success. We've structured the program to run under 45 minutes, which our research shows is the optimal listening period. So we won't take too much of your time. Of course, we can't hope to present everything there is to know in a short session like this, but we will give you all the important highlights so that you'll have a good overview when you've completed the session. For more information, listen to the message at the end of this cassette. Okay? Let's begin. Listen, learn, and enjoy. To tell you more about the material on this tape, here's Tony White, chairman of AMR International. AMR is a leading-edge management education company that teaches top executives through high-quality seminars, courses, and research projects. Tony?
Robert Townsend is the former chief executive officer of Avis Rent-A-Car. He's the man who got Avis to try harder. He's the author of Up the Organization, and now further up the organization. Tom Peters, co-author of In Search of Excellence, has said about Townsend, "Further up the organization should not be just read, it should be memorized. Following Townsend's rules can revolutionize American management practices." And I've said, Townsend's book is one of the most important today on American management practices. Only certain chapters need to be memorized. The others you can get by with reviewing weekly. Bob? You've said that managers don't lead and workers don't work. Why?
Well, the basic problem is that in our big corporations, leaders wait for that corner office. And the corner office brings with it things that make leading impossible. For example, after waiting on the golden escalator for 5 years and keeping his nose clean, the big guy finally gets there. You know, his wife has been tasting it. Well, she's been waiting so long. He gets there. He's got 3 secretaries guarding him from anything unpleasant. He's got a private elevator. He's got a private limousine. He's got all these outside commitments to make speeches on why they're in South Africa. In a matter of 4 months, he's lost touch with all the people who helped him get the job in the first place. He has no eyeball contact with any of the people who are making it happen in his company. He's lost touch with his organization. And, you know, as he rides home in his limousine at night, what does he think? He thinks, my God, I'm paid $1 million a year with all of these club memberships and outside boards and all of this stuff, and I don't know what the f*** is going on. He says, I'm not worth what I'm being paid. And all of this makes him more insecure and more willing to let himself get insulated from the very people he ought to be seeing, which are the dissatisfied customers, the customers who want more from the product or services, from his own dissatisfied employees who can't get their ideas listened to. That's the problem. That's why workers aren't working and why leaders aren't leading.
You characterized it as these individuals are presiding in turn over the demise of their companies. Is this a problem in American industry?
This is the whole answer to the Japanese inroads into our business. It's not that Japanese workers are better than American workers. In fact, quite the opposite is true. I would much rather have an American gang. They're all individuals. They all have different ideas. They're abrasive. They're tough. They're chaotic. And they do first-rate work. It's the managers, it's the leaders up above that are so bad in bringing out the best in their people. Now, the reason I wrote this book is because, fortunately, in America, participative management, or theory Y, is happening. There are big companies out there that are doing very well. Cummins Engine, Hewlett-Packard, Johnson & Johnson, 3M, IBM, Dana Corp, P&G, Honeywell, Control Data, John Deere, Motorola. Motorola, there's a good example. The king of nepotists. It's only been written by the founder and his son is now grooming the grandson to run it. But my God, what a good job they've done. So I got to back off on nepotism. If the family's good enough, let them run it. I think it's great. Anyway, those are participative companies.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.